Today we gonna have our virtual trip to Seberang Cendol. So I'm gonna start with the history of this Seberang Cendol stall. So it was established on 2014 by selling beverage around the UPM area. It then improvised his company by selling this Seberang Cendol after 1 year of establishment. There are actually 30 workers in total that works in shift on 3 different branches around UPM. It operates during weekdays from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. So it is the founder of this company is actually the UPM student itself from Faculty of Engineering, Muhammad Faris Jaafar. I think that's it from the history. I think Zul can elaborate more on significant.
Okay, so now I will continue with the significance of the Seberang Cendol. Okay, so firstly, Seberang Cendol, it is the stall itself is a part of the Faculty of Modern Language and Communication Cafe. Therefore, it allows everyone to enjoy the relaxing venue. So, one of the things that makes it a significant place in UPM area is firstly, like I said before, everyone can enjoy because it's in faculty. So students, lecturers, and sometimes outsiders, you know, people from different faculty came all the way to the that faculty just to enjoy the Seberang Cendol. And secondly, because it's a cafe, it has a lot of space and table. So students can go there to study, and then they can also hang out and relax with their friends. And sometimes can even do like a group discussion for the assignment and all. So since this is a virtual trip, I would like to show you guys. So here is the pamphlet. You can see it has the Seberang Cendol logo here. Next, this Seberang Cendol stall is also close to the bus stop. So it's easier for students to go to the stall. And it is also close to the mosque. So sometimes after you've done your prayer, you want to relax and cool down, you can go to the Seberang Cendol to enjoy their dessert.
Can I interrupt? Wait.
Yeah, sure.
So can I know where the 3 branches of the Seberang Cendol?
The first one is here in the Faculty of Modern Language and Communication Cafe. And then the two is where, Azmi?
One in Faculty of Economy and the other one around the Faculty of Food Technology.
Here you see this is the Faculty of Modern Language and Communication. So what I want to show you guys, if we walk straight out of the gate,
Okay,
here you see this the UPM bus stop. So bus can will stop here. So most of students can access the Seberang Cendol quite easily. And then if you go straight ahead a bit more, you can see if you see behind the trees, let me zoom a bit. So this is the UPM mosque. So it's actually quite close. Quite close to the Seberang stall.
That's a stone's throw away.
How frequent you enjoy this cendol?
Wait, every time I study, what? I come here.
Okay.
So the store should be in this place. So here is the faculty's cafe.
So I'm going to continue with the physical features of this Seberang Cendol stall. Okay, so this Seberang Cendol stall has a unique design of the stall that has a little bit touch on the tradition.
You have a quite bad connection, I see.
Oh yeah, I can see. Can you hear me now?
Can you repeat the last sentence you said?
Okay, I said that it has a little bit touch of Malaysian tradition that makes it more attractive.
Yeah.
It's also located under the shady spot, so it is suitable for people to have some kind of a relax and hang out with the friends. So it is also well managed by the founder, that he allocate 3 workers at the same time, one for delivery, one for making the cendol, and one for taking orders. So that is the good management of the founder. And then they also have a variation of menu, just like what Zos has mentioned. And then they also offers a variation of prices. So it's starting from RM1 ringgit up to 330. Oh, so now, the idea from the founder to generate more income, so they collaborate with the wedding planners and the caterers, so that they can have cendol in that wedding ceremony, so it can generate much more income. So I think anyone has any question about that? What are the special menus that they offer?
Special menus. So firstly, we have the most basic one, a simple cendol. We call it cendol kosong. So it has plain. We have the palm milk and also the green cendol itself. So I think that's the one which is 1 ringgit. And then if you go up a price, you can add red bean, corn, and the most expensive one is the one with glutinous rice. So since the cendol is sweet, you might want something savory to enjoy it with. So that's why they included the menu with glutinous rice.
How much is that?
Okay.
How much is that, Hazmi? How much is it?
What is it?
The
glutinous rice?
Yeah, that one.
Yes. Yeah, it's 3 ringgit.
3 ringgit.
So is it the highest price of all the cendol?
Yeah, I think that's the most.
That is the highest
expensive
price.
Menu.
We call that cendol special. Glutinous rice, corn, red bean and all. Yes.
Okay, so I have a question. Since the most lowest, since nowadays in this area, in this era, okay, so the most lowest they put their price at 1 ringgit, right?
Yes.
So how did they get the profit just put the price on the 1 ringgit, and the highest price you said just 3 ringgit.
So, Hazel, are you sure the lowest price is 1 ringgit? Because I think that one too cheap lah.
Yeah, too cheap for now.
For that kind of dish, I think that one too cheap. Because they put the cendol,
based on the banner that...
Yeah, based on here, from 1 ringgit best offer. Maybe have not updated this one. I'm not sure about that. But yeah, from this...
Because I think ringgit, they just put the corn...
Maybe that is the during promotion time, I think.
Maybe they have changed the price now.
For limited time, I guess.
Limited time.
I think I saw something
for the catering package.
Catering package.
Catering package.
Oh, they want for the catering package. Okay.
So when they sell for students, it's 2 ringgit, the lowest price.
It's quite relevant for now.
Yes.
Yeah.
2 ringgit still affordable for students.
Yes.
I think that's their aim, is to make available for students. It's not just for people who have job, but students who are studying can also afford to buy the cendol.
Yes.
I'm gonna talk a little bit about the challenges that the founder has faced during the entire operation of the company. So he said that it is... Can you hear me?
Can you repeat the sentence again?
Okay, he said that it is a little bit challenge. I know it's challenging how they manage to become to be a student, athlete and entrepreneur at the same time. But this doesn't discourage him or let him down. Otherwise, he's happy to be venturing this new field of new field for him, other than being an engineering student. So he has not faced so many challenges during the operation, as the student UPM student support him so well. But there's only challenge that he faced. The greatest challenge that he faced is that the sale will be a little bit dropped during the rainy season, as the student will not enjoy their cendol during cold weather again. So I think that what he exposed to the media, saying that it's not, plus, the sale will be dropped.
Plus the cafe doesn't have a proper permanent roof. They're just using like portable tents. So sometimes when it's raining, it's not very comfortable for the students to enjoy their foods there.
Yes. In addition, students that might go to the stall just by bike, then students can't afford to have. Not all students can afford to have a car, right? So that's the reason why.
Harder for students to get there when it's rain.
Yeah, agree.
Yeah, you agree?
Yes.
Okay, good.
And can I know what the year of that student that entrepreneur the stalls?
We're not really sure, but I've stated earlier that he's from engineering student. He established the store during 2004, during the year of his study. He may be graduate around that year.
So the final year. Final year.
Yeah, maybe like someone like that.
Very good idea, actually.
Yes. We have to put that entrepreneurship ideas in all of us.
Yes.
I think later we start
something. Our stall. What is it, Mo?
I think later we also can have our stall at our faculty, I guess.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe we can start.
We do our own business there.
I've heard that you are Putra Biz members.
Yes, I'm Putra Biz member.
But
I'm no longer.
No longer. Okay.
Yes, member. Azman.
Yes.
How about the shawl?
It's doing great. Okay, so
you try something.
Think that
what is
me?
That?
You think what? As me? What do you think?
How many minutes left?
I'm not sure. I did not keep track of the time.
Oh, can you
I thought you want to say you did not record.
No, it's recording. Don't worry.
It's recording, okay. So I think it's exceed 15 minutes. Do you guys think so? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think we can end this discussion.
Yeah, final words is I think that since our team is fun and lively, and cendol is a delicacy that every Malaysian can enjoy, and the place is quite nice with large space. So the Serdang Cendol stall fits the criteria for our team, which is fun and lively.
Okay. Yes. So, all right.
With that, we end our discussion. Our virtual trip for Serdang Cendol.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
All right. Bye-bye. See you again. See you
next week.